What's good, YouTube? I thought that I'd come here and make this video for you guys today. How are you? I'm in my bathroom because I was doing my makeup and so on. I tried to get the Halloween look, but it just didn't pop off the way it should have. I don't know what's going on here, but I got the orange. I got the black in the corners. I got the black lipstick with the little orange ombre going. I thought that I had that going on, but you know what? It is what it is. Who cares? You know what I'm saying? My videos is all about spreading the love. So if you got videos where you did a messed up makeup look, you post it and you be proud about it. But this look was really pushing towards Halloween. This is not how I normally would go outside and wear my makeup or anything. I could also say that this is my San Francisco Giants look, which is my baseball team. But it's not. It's the Halloween look, okay? You know, it's the Halloween look. Come on. Anyway, so I thought that I'd come here and spread some love to you guys. I hope don't nobody call through while I'm doing this video. But I just wanted to make this video to put all jokes to the side, to let everybody know that I'm about to take off this black lipstick and put on the orange pumpkin spice while I'm talking to y'all. But I just wanted to let y'all know that I'm spreading my word. Okay. And I know you guys are probably like, what word are you spreading? You know, you say this every time you make a video. Well, I am, and I'm gonna keep on saying it. I usually go into my Facebook profile and do my, where I live at different. I actually put it here. You know, here where I normally live. And so I, hold on, guys. I don't know if you guys are, are members with, Kiss Me, but this color that I have is called Pumpkin Spice. And I like it. It's really, really cute. And not to mention apple cider is cute too. So anyway, so I just thought that I'd come and share with you guys just to let you know that I'm expanding and I've added two ladies to my crew. I don't know how they are about speaking, but for me, bullying comes too close to home, and I just like to spread that word, and I just like to get it out there and let everybody know that people are here to help you. So they want what they want to do, and what I had in mind to do as well, is to gather up a certain amount of people. So if you know anybody who is willing to share their story, who is willing to talk about it, I don't care if you want to put that you are anonymous and have us read it, we can do that for you. I don't care if you want to put your name, and maybe you could even go live with me one day on Facebook and you can talk about it from there, and we can take it from there, because this is a subject that a lot of people don't like to touch. People don't like to mess with bullying subjects because sometimes people are afraid they might think that their kids might get bullied more, or the situation might just infuse and go from right to left really quick and just spiral out of control. But we are here to let you know that as long as you have a support group, that won't never happen. Understand that, okay? So with that being said, I'm hoping that we can get a bunch of people that just wants to come and just talk and tell your story. I'm leaving my comment section open. So when you come in, come and tell your story. However, let me tell you something. When you come in, and if you decide to tell your story in the comment box, there's people that might come and be mean, but just know that those comments will not stand long. Those comments will be attacked immediately and taken off, and they will be blocked. Okay, so then that way that you won't have to worry about that. Or if you feel like you just want to email us, you can email me at vkyjones76@yahoo.com, and you can just tell me your story and let me know what's going on, if it's still happening. When was it happening? How old were you? You know, some people at an adult age are still getting bullied on. Whether it's through work, whether it's through a spouse, whether it's through kids at home, your own kids, or even family members. And that's not fair. So we just need to stop this, and we need to show people how we can put an end to it. My whole thing, what I'm doing is trying to help the youth, the young girls, to cope with not having friends, going to school, being alone, walking alone, seeing other people being in big groups of friends, and you ain't got a friend at first, and then the schools are not helping. You know, that's what we want to attack. We want schools to understand that we as parents, we are there for our children. But when we put our children in your care for 6 hours, there's no way in hell I should be at home stressed out, worrying about how my kid's day is going and if they're going to be making friends or if they're going to walk around alone at lunchtime and you teachers are not doing nothing about it. And so that's my whole situation. And let me just tell you guys something. You guys might ask, have you ever been bullied, Miss Victoria? I have. Yes, I have. I'm going to tell y'all my story. Long time ago when I was a little girl, I was bullied at school when I was in second grade. It had to have been second, first grade. And the little girl kept bothering me. And she kept bothering me every day. She would mess with me and she would say, oh, she thinks she's cool. Oh, she thinks she Mexican. Oh, she thinks she white. She don't want no black friends. It is that and the other. And she just kept going. You think back on things like that and you say, how could a 5-year-old, 5 or 6-year-old have that kind of vocabulary? Comes from the upbringing. It really does. And when you living in a place and you got siblings, maybe your siblings might be doing it to you, or you just might see it at home or outside, or it might just be getting somebody at home might be doing it to you outside. And so she just kept bothering me. And then one day I had a high jump that I made at home, and I'll never forget this. I turned around and I said, here, you could have it. And I gave it to her, and then she was my friend from there. But that wasn't happening. My cousin came into the situation, and he, bless his heart, and he approached her, and he was like, give her her shit back. You know, how did he gain that kind of vocabulary at the age he was at? It was because when we were younger, everybody cussed, okay? I ain't gonna even lie. And he was like, give her shit back. And the girl was like, no, she gave it to me. And then he beat her up, and he was like, I beat you up because don't think I didn't see you messing with my cousin every day. And I know that he wasn't supposed to hit on the girls, you know what I'm saying? But we were little, you know what I'm saying? And he knew and seen that this little girl was bothering me every single solitary day, and I was a really quiet kid. And so ever since he did all that, She never messed with me ever again. And as time went on, I would see her and stuff. And then later on, as we got older and adults, and I seen her, and she had been using drugs. And I just was so saddened by that, because I'm like, you know, she gave me a really hard time in school, but do she deserve to be this way? No, she don't, you know. But that's the type of bullying I dealt with. I dealt with one time when I was younger. I didn't even do anything to one girl. A girl just was bothering me in the elevator, and I was on my way up to go and get go home. And she was bothering me, and I yelled at her, and I said, leave me alone. And she slapped shit out of me. She slapped me so hard my whole face was stinging. And I was crying, and when my auntie came outside the hallway, she ran. So my auntie never seen her. She's another one on drugs now to this day, really, really bad. So, you know, bullying comes in different ways. Bullying can come through guys. They can come through your teachers. I remember I had a teacher who used to always tell me I wasn't going to amount to nothing and I wasn't going to be anything. And come to find out, as I got into my adult years, I found out that I wasn't the only student he told that to. He told that to a lot of students. And so we found out that he passed away from cancer. And then there was this one girl in the group that we were talking, and she was like, F him. He gave me a hard time in school. He always used to tell me I wasn't going to amount to shit, and I wasn't going to be shit, and I wasn't nobody. And she was like, he deserved to die. And most of us was like, nah, no, he didn't. Don't do that. Don't say that. And so we learned to deal with those things and cope with those things when we were younger. I mean, as we got older, but you know, it's so hard. You look back and you reflect on those times when you really had been given a hard time when you were younger, and you say, I thank the Lord, whoever's in the universe, that I made it. You know what I'm saying? Because there are some students nowadays that kill themselves, that get on drugs, and it's all because of what is going on in the schools. And so what? Yeah. And so, you know, there were times when nowadays it's kids that can't even go to the schools and talk. My daughter, it took her forever to get through to the teachers. And she finally came home and told me and broke down crying telling me. And I'm like, oh, wow, really? And then come to find out the person that was part of it was used to be her best friend, and now she's not her friend. But like that, where did that come from? And now they're not the cool kids. I don't call them the cool kids. They're not gonna get that word from me. They're the bad kids, and they go walk around. They give people hell. And so I'm just like, wow, that's not fair. That's not right. And I wanted to tell the teachers, but it kept going on. So I went to the school. I said something to the students, and I told the students, look, you're not going to do this and get away with it, okay? What is it that you're wanting from my child? Because you're going to tell me. And when the other little girl got ready to come to school, I approached her grandmother and told her grandmother, because I'm like, I know you. I can come to you. I expect for you as an adult to clean up the situation, but they didn't clean up the situation either. You know, they just let the situation kind of hang over, like, you know what I'm saying? So, so now I'm just like, whatever. I'm like, you know, I washed my hands with it. And so all I know is if anything else happened to my child, if they say one more word at her, I'm coming up to this school, and it's not going to be pretty. It's not going to be beautiful. And that's it, and that's all, okay? Because you're lucky I ain't coming with no 4 o'clock Channel 4 news or no polices to arrest their parents for allowing their kids to come out like that. Only time there was one kid that was part of the mayhem, and she apologized to my daughter, wrote my daughter a letter, and apologized to me. And then when I tell you that baby didn't say not one mumbling word to my daughter ever again, she didn't say nothing else to her. She don't go to the school no more. So that's good. She don't hang out with the girls no more. But now they just got more and more that just hang out. And I'm like, you know what, guys? This stuff with my daughter and that little girl not being friends no more is old. Okay, let it go and go about your business. Because if I got to take out my time and come back to this school and say one more word to any of these students about bullying, it's going to be hell. And that's how it should be. I do love Spider-Man. And if you have kids that are being bullied, you need to put a nip in the bud ASAP. Do not allow these schools to not do any. Uzziah! Do not allow these schools to not do anything about it, because that's why kids come home till this day and kill themselves, because they're so afraid. They won't tell a parent. They won't tell a parent. They won't tell an adult. They won't tell a teacher. They'd rather just go on go on their day and just be afraid and be stressed out rather than to tell an adult. But I nip it in the bud quick because I know my kids' strengths and I know their weaknesses. And when things are bothering them, they come straight home and they go to bed and they go to sleep. That's what they do when they leave, when they come home. That's what they do. Or they will walk around and they would be really, really upset and hostile with everybody in the house. Okay, so then I have to ask them what's going on. See, Dad, he thinks he knows them, but he doesn't. Like, literally, you don't. Like, my daughter, when she used to come in here, anytime she would come into the house when she was younger, when she used to go to school, I would know it was an issue. I knew as soon as she came in the house. If my daughter ever came in the house and she gave you that dry, hi, Mom, hi, Dad, and went straight to her room and didn't come back out, that's how I know she had a messed up day. If my daughter come into the house and she's like, hey, Mom, hey, Dad, and then she'll go and put her stuff down and she'll come back out and she'll just come get water or whatever, I knew she had a good day. It was never an in-between day. It was always either a good day or a bad day. And because kids knew that they could take her over the top, that's how they would do. So I would go and ask her. And sometimes she never wanted to talk. I'd never left it alone because that's what you don't do. When kids are having trouble in school, you don't leave it alone and let them tell you, leave me alone. I don't want to talk about it. You talk about it because you can diffuse the situation quick. Okay, so me and my ladies, Tia and Tina, we are coming up with something where we can just have you guys come in and do what it is you want to do. Talk to us, email us, communicate with us, be friends with us on Facebook. Come watch our makeup videos. Come watch my jewelry videos. Tia is amazing. She does a lot of different things with makeup. She does Foundation Thursdays. She does videos where she comes and she does her eyebrows to show you how to do your eyebrows. So, ladies, she will lift you up. Now, I ain't there yet with the eyebrows, but I do my makeup videos. And I do my makeup videos. Girl, you got to come get the door. And my makeup videos is dedicated to all women that are suffering from something, whether it's a disease, whether it's cancer, AIDS, HIV, cystic fibrosis, lupus, pulmonary fibrosis, anything you might be suffering from that might give you pain throughout your day, that might make it hard for you. That's who I do my videos for. I have NF1. You see all these right here, except for these right here. This one, except for these two right here. But the rest of them are my neurofibromas. And I have them all over. So anybody who want to come in and watch me do my makeup, I can't cover these, but I definitely can give you a look that'll be like, okay, then maybe I should try to do my makeup. Yes, you should. Yes, you should do your makeup. Don't try, do it, because you will get it done. Don't let nobody tell you that you're not worth it. Don't let nobody tell you that you're ugly. This look that I got today, I might get 1,001 people that might come to me and say, what were you thinking? You look ugly. That look a mess. What makes you think that look good? What am I going to say to them? Nothing. The best thing you can do to a hater is ignore them and delete their comment and let them keep on pushing. Some say don't block them so that they can keep watching. But if you don't block them, they are going to continuously come back and give you hell on your on your line and on your YouTube comments and on your Facebook timeline. So you gotta block them so you could shut them up. And that's the best thing that you can do for people. So I'm here for children. I'm here for adults. I'm here for teens, tweens. I want to say that I'm here for the young men, but I can't tell a young man how to conduct themselves in public and so on and so forth, like how an actual man can do it. But I'm willing to help and try. Okay, I'm willing to help. That's, you hear the word willing to help. Okay, here's the thing. We want to come together with this organization. Mine's, I forgot the name again, but it'll get put in one of my videos very, very soon. And when I get it, I'm going to make sure that I introduce it to you guys, because it's going to be a website that's going to be put up. This takes some time. I'm staying consistent with it. I'm trying to get donations. I'm trying to get people to donate from all over. I don't care if it's just them donate. Uh-oh, I'm getting dizzy. I'm sorry, guys. I don't care if it's papers. Like, say, for instance, for the younger kids, I want them to donate Elmer's glue so we can make slime. For the tweens and the teens, I want them to donate lip glosses, lipsticks, shadows, and so on and so forth. So maybe one day I can take them, bring them here, and we can set up shop here, and we can be like, okay, ladies, bring your daughters in tonight. We're going to teach them how to put a proper shadow on. We're going to teach them how to do their lipstick. We're going to teach them how to know that, okay, we're not going to put a lot of makeup, but we're going to make y'all look good tonight. Get them some treats. Get them some nice sodas or juices or what have you. Put some nice shows on TV and let them just have a ball, or maybe even some music and let them just have a ball. Hold on. And just escape being around the bullying, escape school, escape the teachers that won't do anything for them when they're being bullied, when they come and they try to tell them that somebody is bothering them. Do you know how many girls are being bullied day in and day out at school? Like, don't come to school tomorrow. If you come to school tomorrow, we whooping you over, you know what. And then the girl is doing everything she can to not go to school. But she got that parent that drops her off, so she gotta go to school. Or she might even turn back around and just wander the streets because she don't want to go to school because she's so afraid. Or you got that little girl who goes to school every day and don't have not one friend. And then here it is, these big time teachers, yard duties, is not even trying to approach the situation. Me, personally speaking, if I worked in a school with yard duty and I seen the kid walking by themselves, I'd go up to that kid straight up and I'd tell them, well, why are you walking by yourself? Where's your friends? Nobody wants to be your friend. Okay. Well, you know what? Let's go find you a friend. Let's go see if anybody would love to hang out with you and be friends with you. But it's up to you to keep the friend. That's what I'd be wanting to tell people when they say that, especially my daughter. Okay, so enough of me jibber jabbering. I thought that I'd come and I'd spread that to you guys just to let you know what we got going on and things like that. Visit me. Don't forget, guys. Visit me over. I'm in Snapchat too. That, you know, let me tell you something. I'm at Snapchat, Battle with Satan. I was over on Periscope listening to music, and a lady was like, oh, Battle with Satan, you're not battling with Satan, change your name, don't do that to yourself. And so I just changed it over there, so whatever. Okay. I am on Periscope though. I don't mind talking on Periscope as well. Facebook is Victoria Jones. Okay. Email is V like Victor, KY Jones 76@yahoo.com. That's my email. If you want to come over to my Instagram, Vicky Marie, not Vicky, but Vika Marie the Gemini, at over there at Instagram. Where else am I at? That's it. So, you know, y'all know how to contact me. Okay, just contact me. Let me know what it is that you guys are looking for, what we can do to help you. Let us know your story. We do not, I repeat, we will not repeat anything you tell us. Unless you say, okay, it's okay to spread my story. But if you come in as anonymous, or if you come in and you tell us who you are and you just tell us, please don't say nothing to nobody, I won't. And they won't as well. We'll keep this all between you and us, okay? Unless you want to really post your story and write it yourself, okay? And then maybe somewhere in my description, like if you go my about me, you'll see my P.O. box. If you want to write me, you can write me as well. And then you can give me permission to read over your story over the the internet, and then that's how we can kind of capture some people, and people can kind of give advice on what you should do and what you shouldn't do and what you should step away from and so on and so forth. Okay, so with that being said, you guys have a beautiful night. I hope to see you guys in my inboxes. I hope to see you guys on our Facebooks. I hope to see you on my YouTube. I hope to help you ladies. I hope to just get the word out there. I know I sound like I'm just really, really excited, but I am when it comes to helping out people. I really am. So anyway, with that being said, you guys, I am going to go and I will see you next time, okay? Don't forget to subscribe. And if you really want more about us, don't forget to hit that notification button, okay? All right, guys. Bye. Look at me. I look a hot mess. I look a hot mess, but it's for Halloween. All right, y'all. Bye.